हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म आवर सेकंड इलेक्ट्रिकल ड्राइव्स लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट व्हिच इज टू स्टडी द स्पीड टॉर्क कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डीसी सीरीज मशीन। स्टूडेंट्स, फॉर टॉर्क स्पीड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डीसी सीरीज मशीन वी अप्लाई फर्स्ट डिफरेंट वोल्टेजेस एंड आफ्टर दैट वी कनेक्ट वन सीरीज एक्सटर्नल रेजिस्टेंस फॉर डिफरेंट आर्मेचर रेजिस्टेंस। Students, we start the DC series motor with load because in case of DC series motor, due to its high starting torque, it always started with load. Otherwise, motor will be damaged. For high starting torque causes high current flows. For that, we connect one high range DC ammeter for the armature current measurement. Here is the setup for our DC series machine experiment. Here we provide AC supply. This one actually rectifier circuit and it converts AC to DC. And we connect DC supply in field and armature terminals of motor. Okay. Here the DC ammeter. Students, we consider now 10 ampere higher range because for its starting torques, it flows high current in motor. That's why we consider one DC ammeter high range. Okay? So, students, this is the circuit diagram. Here, we provide AC in rectifier circuit. After rectifier circuit, it connects field, then we connect one ammeter, and after that we connect the armature. Okay? So students, we measure the rotor circumference. For this motor, this circumference actually 63 centimeter, this one. Okay? So, we know rotor circumference 2πr equals to 63 centimeter. Now, r radius equal to 10.0267 centimeter. So, students, if we applied voltage equals to now 80 volt DC and our current suppose 4.5 ampere, then our first load suppose M1 equals to 3 kg, then M2 equals to 0 to 25 kg. Then we know torque equals to M1 minus M2 into ZR equals to KI square. So after that we got K equals to 0.133. Okay? Students, here is the drive arrangement of series motor. Suppose this one M1 and this one M2. Okay? Now we start our experiment. First we consider our voltage is 80 volt, okay? And we calculate our armature resistance, then speed, then torque. For torque measurement, we consider the formula of KI square, okay? We know K equals to 0.133, okay? In variable armature currents, we measure the speed. Students, now we run our DC series motor. Here we consider M1 equals to 3 kg, this one, and M2 equals to 0.25 kg. In this condition, our armature current is now 4.5 ampere. Okay? And here we measure the supply voltage. See, it almost 80 volt. Okay? So, here we write our supply voltage now, armature current is 4.5 ampere. Now we check our speed, then torque. Okay? For speed measurement,
we use this tachometer. Almost 720. Okay. Now the speed is 720.
Torque is now 2.70 Newton meter by using KI square formula. Okay. So students, again we take second reading in 80 voltage. We take the armature current, then speed, then torque. Okay. Now we calculate armature current, how much it is. See, it almost 4 ampere. Okay. Now check its 4 ampere. Here we write 4 ampere. Now we check the RPM. So students, our second reading 80 volt, then 4 ampere hour armature current, then 765 rpm hour speed, and torque equals to now 2.13 Newton meter. Okay. Now again we check armature current, then speed, then we calculate torque. So students, for third readings, see our armature current now 3.4 ampere. Okay, so here we write armature current 3.4 ampere, and we calculate our speed now. Nine sixty-seven is RPM. Now we calculate torque. Now the torque is 154 Newton meter. Okay. For fourth reading, see students, our armature current now is 3 ampere. Here we write 3 ampere. Now we measure speed. RPM. Now we calculate torque. Torque is 1.20 Newton meter. Okay. Again, we take readings in 80 volt. Now, students, again we change the load. It 2.5 ampere in 80 volt, 2.5 ampere hour armature current. Now we take speed. Now the speed is 1328 RPM. Okay. Now we calculate torque. So students, now the torque is 0.831 Newton meter. We consider 5 steps in constant voltage. We apply 80 volt and take several armature currents, speed, then torque. Okay. So students, in our offline class, actually we consider 3 more steps. Suppose after 80 volt we consider 100 volt input supply, after that 120 volt, again we calculate armature current, speed, then torque. for our speed torque characteristics of DC series motor. Okay, so students, you make one observe characteristics graph for our DC series motor like this. Okay, for speed you consider this axis and torque you consider this axis. Okay, hope you student understood the experiment of our torque speed characteristics of DC series machine. In next class we connect one external resistance for taking the readings of speed and torque. Thank you all.